behind special relativity, as postulated by Einstein, special relativity. Now, here, let me first give you the first two postulates, which forms the basis, the foundation stone for special relativity. Now, special relativity becomes the superset on which classical Newtonian mechanics rests. So, it is the superset within which classical Newtonian mechanics rests. Now, what are the postulates of special relativity? One of the postulates of relativity is that all physical laws, all fundamental physical laws over here remains the same physical laws are invariant to an inertial frame essentially we're saying that for every inertial frame, the basis on which we write the physical laws, that means the effect, the cause and the effect are nothing but the same. An inertial frame. The second postulate is a very, very important postulate. It says that the speed of light is constant no matter how fast the source is moving. Speed of light is a universal constant. In fact, it is in vacuum, with respect to vacuum, universal constant no matter how, and it does not depend upon the speed of the source. Now, with this, we come to some basic, we call them transformations of length, time and mass of source. Now, let me write down the fundamental transformation, and before that let me write down the correction factor, because at objects which are moving near the speed of light in vacuum, there is a Lorentz factor. Lorentz factor is basically a correction factor which you have to write in traditional classical mechanics to factor in the above two postulates. So, Lorentz factor again. One second. Lorentz factor or the correction factor. The correction factor. Now, in the Lorentz factor or correction factor, we write FR is nothing but under root 1 minus v square, where v is the velocity of the object in the inertial frame, and of course c is the velocity of time. Now, this gives rise to certain phenomena. Now, these phenomena can be subdivided into three basic categories. One is mass dilation. Now, you will be going through all of this in the regular classes, but here this is just a snapshot of what you could expect in this topic. One is mass dilation. Now, in mass dilation over here, we have m equal to m naught by under root 1 minus v square by c square, and second of all, where m naught is the rest mass, m naught is the rest mass in that particular inertial frame. The second is time dilation. Time dilation is again when time is, there is a change in the fabric of time. Time dilation. In time dilation over here, we have t equal to, or t prime equal to t by, again 1 by v square by c square, where time, again over here, is the time at rest. Let me write it as t naught. T naught is the time at rest. So basically, special relativity is all about you trying to find out which is your inertial frame, and with respect to which frame are you computing all the changes in mass, all the changes in time. And the third one is the change in length, which I'm scrolling to the right and I'm writing it, and then I'm scrolling to the at the top. So the last one is nothing but about length dilation. Now, in length dilation, fundamentally, you're looking at basically L becomes equal to L naught into under root 1 minus V square by C square. In fact, we might not call it length dilation here, it's length contraction basically. This is length contraction. So again, L naught is the length at a particular inertial frame which is at rest. So length contraction, or where you are the observer. So L naught is the length where the inertial frame is at rest. At rest means you are the observer. You are observing everything with respect to that inertial frame, and accordingly you are bringing about the calibration, the changes in the in time, length, as well as mass, inertial frame. Now, over here, let us solve, see, a few questions over here. Suppose there is a space vehicle which is accelerated at, let me write it over here, let me go to another whiteboard, let me change the background color. Suppose a space vehicle is accelerated at 0.85c. So it's very near to the speed of light. Now, over here, suppose it leaves the solar system. Now, a year later, a stationary observer, a year later a stationary observer, observes, watches the vehicle pass, and measures the length pass and measures the length. Now over here, measures the length of the vehicle, to be 12.64 meters. Now, what is the length of the vehicle on Earth? The question is, what is the length of the vehicle on Earth once it leaves, before leaving for its trip? Is it fine? Before leaving for its trip. Now, see, let me read the question again. A space vehicle is accelerated at 0.85 c. It's very near to the speed of light. A year later, a stationary observer watches the vehicle pass and measures the length of the vehicle to be 12.64 meters. Now, what is the length of the vehicle on Earth before leaving for its trip? So, how do you solve this problem? Precisely what formula do you use? So we use the length contraction formula over here. So can we not write, see, it measures the length of the vehicle to be 12.64 meters. So this becomes our, if I change the color a bit over here, L becomes equal to L naught under root 1 by 1 minus V square by C square. So what is your L? L is nothing but, in this case, is the final length, and you are the observer from the Earth. So this becomes 12.64, and you need to find out L naught. So L naught is the unknown quantity in this equation. If L naught is the unknown quantity, then automatically we have 12.60 is equal to L naught under root 1 minus, this becomes 0.85 whole square. So C square gets cancelled out. This is nothing but over here. From this, we can get L naught is approximately equal to 24 meters. So see, we are using length contraction formula to find out the initial length of the spaceship. Now, I'll just introduce another problem, another problem over here. Now, suppose, what about if an object is accelerated to near an object to near the speed of light, what will happen to its mass? The speed of light, what will happen to its mass over here? What would happen, or what prediction can you make about its mass? What would happen to its mass? Which mass? It is nothing but m naught by 1 minus v square by c square, and this is your m. So therefore, see, from here we can see that the mass decreases. A logical question might arise as to what will happen to this decrease in mass. Where does the mass go? So for this, we come to the famous equation E equal to mc square. That means a mass has an energy equivalent. So if a mass is accelerated near the speed of light, that mass slowly gets converted into energy. And this is one of the main principles guiding nuclear reactions. This is one of the main principles guiding the concept of binding energy, nuclear reactions over here. Concept of binding energy, that means it binds the nucleus together. Concept of binding energy. So see, special relativity has enormous applications, and it turns around Newtonian world. So the Newtonian mechanics that you are studying is basically a small part of relativity, where the speeds of the object are not equivalent to the speed of light, or rather the speeds of the object here, the speeds of the object, let me write it in this way, speeds of the objects that you are studying is much less than the speed of light. This is the realm of whatever you have done in Newton's mechanics. Now, I have not dealt with momentum and also energy considerations per se in the relativity, but they do form an integral part of special relativity. Let me just draw an arrow here and see, this is Newtonian classical mechanics. So in SAT they will give you different problems based on mass contraction, time dilation, mass contraction, and mass and length. Let me just write it down so that it is very, very clear. Length contraction, time dilation, and mass dilation. Am I right? Time dilation and mass over here. Mass dilation. Is it fine? Right. It is completely based upon that. Mass, length contraction, time dilation, and mass dilation. And third is mass dilation. Now, there is one small point I would like to highlight. This is the point. If it is accelerated, an object is accelerated, mass decreases with respect to energy over here. Here I wrote mass decreases with respect to energy. That means a part of it is converted to energy. But if you are looking at only the equations over here, let me be very, very clear. M is equal to M naught under root 1 minus V square by C square. So mass increases. You do not take energy into consideration. Let me be very clear. Mass increase. Is it fine? So make this change. Make a small note. The mass increase. If a mass is moving at a huge speed, it converts into energy. But if you are not looking at energy, if you are just looking at the mass per se, the mass increases. Clear? So with this, we come to the end of this topic, special relativity. It forms an important part of SAT. Please do go through all the different types of contraction and expansion over here, and also the Lorentz factor, and mostly and most importantly, determine your inertial frame. Determine the inertial frame. Is it fine? Inertial frame. This is of paramount importance when solving problems. So if you have any queries, any doubts, anything whatsoever, any questions to ask whatsoever, please write at info@testprepcard.com for you. So thank you all. Any queries, any issues, please write at this particular mail and you will be contacted immediately as soon as possible. So thank you.